Okay, designs and inspirations. This was one suit, one of those multitude of suits that come in for sewing where the machinists find it difficult to stitch something which comes as a piece of fabric and comes with a picture of sort of something like this sort. This particular one that was stitched actually was used using the full fabric of what was supplied, and it was done in a gathered type. She didn't want this because of her figure size. She would not have suited this type, and she wanted it done in an A-line. She had difficulty explaining it to the machinist, so obviously it landed on my doorstep. And we normally try not to disappoint anyone and try and do our best to do the outfits. Now, the good bit of, I mean, it's very basic A-line camise, and really there wasn't all that to actually sew a show from this. It came in the fabric form, and obviously we had to piece it all together and stitch it to make it look like this. This is the back of the dress and the front. Only a couple of things that you have to be very, very careful on sewing something like this is the trimmings. You need to make sure that the alignment of these actually matches to get a good end result. Now, that this is the actual suit, but what I wanted to share with you is the fascinating little suit that I created from the leftovers of this one. And now, it was quite amazing, because what had happened was, the pieces that I had taken out from the A-line shape, and there was odd bits of embroidery pieces like this from the fabric that was left. And what I did was I cut out all these pieces like this, and then I've put them with some chiffon, and I've created one of the most prettiest outfits to date for Baby Anaya. So I'm going to film her later on, and I'm going to share that video with you of what it looks like. I didn't do the tutorial on it because it was a sort of a last minute attempt to do that, and sometimes I just get carried away momentarily. I wasted a good an hour and a half doing that, but you know what, when I saw her dressed in that, it was well worth every minute of the time that I spent doing that particular outfit. Okay, that was just from the leftovers of that I had created, obviously, the baby outfit. Now, this is an outfit that you may have seen me do in this tiger print. I've done the other dress. I don't know if I've got that line around somewhere as well. It's actually one of those gypsy type of dresses that I did. But initially, when people saw this lace and they saw this fabric, they didn't think anything of it. Since I put this fabric, hung this suit on a doll in the shop, within moments of actually putting this on, I had nearly sold out of the whole of the fabric. And the reason for that was this wonderful combination that came from the two, combining the lace and the fabric and this plain fabric. The result just blew everybody away. Very easy and simple to do neckline, so simple, no interfacing, nothing used in it, and the result was absolutely phenomenal. I've had this hanging in the shop, and just everybody's just come and just gone absolutely crazy about it. The beauty of it is that it's very comfortable, it's very pretty, very effective, and durable. So that's something that, the only difficulty I had with this outfit, I could have sold out of the whole of the lot of the fabric in a day. The only difficulty I had was trying to locate this lace. So for this, now I have to go back to Bradford and to actually purchase more of this. This was just one of the outfits that I had done, which I didn't actually, these are just very simple, very basic sewing techniques. So we've covered these in many of the lessons before, and I haven't gone on to do the repeated tutorial on this. Now this one, when I cut this out to stitch it up, my machinist actually turned around and said to me, I don't really think much of this design. It's a net and black fabric that I've combined together with the lace to actually make this. Now the front of this, I've done it like a little bit like a jacket style, and he wasn't overly inspired when I was showing him this, but the result, as you can see, is quite phenomenal. The sleeves also I've done out of the net, the upper portion of this I've done out of the net, picked up on the lace and the combinations, and that basically is what it's an A-line camise with a red trim at the bottom with a trouser, and that's what it looks like. It is a mind-blowing outfit once she wears this. I mean, the reason why we went on to do this outfit was this is a friend of mine's outfit, and she came into the shop and she had a bag from Accessorize, and the combination of that bag was exactly these colors. So I actually encouraged her to buy this outfit after looking at her bag, and I said, you know what, I'll do you an outfit to go with your bag and it will look absolutely gorgeous. And I didn't want to give it to her yesterday. She came in and I said, I won't give it to you yet because I want to share this with my viewers. So that's just one of the other outfits. Now the third one, or the fourth one, that I'm doing for her is Anarkali. These are all actually belong to the same person. It's Anarkali dress in this little polka dot print. I haven't put the sleeves on, and the reason why we've left it half done is because I wanted to get some trimming to go at the bottom of it. A beautiful cut, absolutely a beautiful cut and a beautiful drape to this. And I will go on to show you the making of this proper summery dress, you know, absolutely gorgeous. Now the fabric of this, so cheap, and the result you can get with it is mind-blowing. So I would say, you know what, look into making some outfits like these for over the summer weeks. I mean, even an abaya out of this would look gorgeous. A maxi dress out of this would look gorgeous. A summer dress, even if it was sleeveless and, you know, a halter neck type, that would look gorgeous. So the stuff that you can do with this is absolutely amazing, and hopefully I shall share some of my ideas with you to actually help you improve and enhance your sewing experiences. So do subscribe to the website, do leave your comments, and I will talk to you again soon, perhaps with once this is finished. I will share this with you because I have made one of these for myself, so perhaps I will go on to actually give you a little bit of a glimpse and model this for you. So I've got a dash now, and so much to do and so little time. Do keep me in your duas, and keep me, you know, remember me in your prayers. I shall see you probably next Sunday now. Well, no, actually before that. Hopefully, if all goes well, I will share the images of how the event goes on the 16th of May, where I will be having luncheon with the Queen. So I'm quite excited about that. Am I excited? I'm not really too excited. I'm not really bothered. My daughter Halima keeps saying to me, Mum, you know, you're over the moon, you're this, you're that. I'm not really, you know what. But it's very rare that we get opportunities like that. So make the most of the opportunities, and you all have a nice day, and I shall see you again soon.